press on the gingiva, on the implant, it's good enough for everything that you need. We made a temporary bridge right on top of the implant that she had.
Hi, and welcome back to Uniqa Dental Show, where we discuss interesting cases and new procedures in the field of dentistry. Don't forget to send us your cases so we can view them also. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. With us today, as always, is Dr. Yaniv.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm amazing. This quarantine is killing me. How about you?
Great.
So, what do we have here?
Here we see very old bridge that was made probably from zirconia with gingiva from composite material. Mm-hmm. You can see all the pigmentation, you can see all the colors that it absorbed during those years. And when we removed the bridge, we saw that from the teeth it was based on, there is not much left. So these teeth are hopeless and you need to extract them all and make implants. In here you see the teeth being, after the removal of the bridge, you can also see that she had a couple of short bridges in the posterior areas on multi-units, here on two implants, there on three. And you can see the teeth after some preparation and cleaning.
What are the metal parts in the scissors?
Those teeth had root canal treatment and long time before the previous bridge was made. And they had a Poston core installed in the root canal treatment for better fixation of the bridge.
Why to make a bridge and not just to remove all the teeth and make a denture?
First of all, you have posterior implants. You always want to have an implant-based dentures. A bridge is also a denture, but implant-based. To make a full denture for this case, it won't hold. She won't have a satisfying function with this denture. You don't do it. Never. Never, ever, ever. If you can't have some implants, it's always best to make even dentures on some implants. In here, you have a lot of bone. So you can just replace the old bridge with a new one, implant-based. On enough implants, you have posterior implants, you just need to add 3-4 implants in the anterior area, and you have enough implants to hold it.
And these multi-units are screw-retained?
Yeah, on multi-units they are screw-retained, all bridges that was made long time ago probably. Yeah, you can see that what we chose to do is to extract those teeth, leave for now the two central incisors. Because for the provisional bridge, for the temporary restoration, you want to have, first of all, you want to make the restoration on those implants. But you can make a horseshoe like this without any anterior support, without any support here. It just will press on the gingiva, on the implants, and it can harm the implants that are installed above this bridge. So we left those two teeth remaining. We made a bridge that was made on two implants on one side, three on the other side, and the frontal area on two teeth.
And the two frontal teeth will hold the bridge even after they were treated the root canal treatment?
The root canal is a long time ago.
Yeah, but they're strong enough?
For temporary restoration, for 3-4 months to wait for the implants to go through the osseointegration, through all this process, yeah, it will hold. You don't have any other option? You need to assess if the teeth are good enough to hold and maintain this period of time. Because if the teeth are in caries and you can't do anything, it's not possible. You need to think about something else. But if these teeth are not reconstructable, you can make a permanent restoration that you can guarantee success, you still can have a temporary restoration for 3-4 months. It doesn't mean that it will fail.
No. Oh, I see. Okay.
You can see here the two teeth. You can see three implants, two implants. And this was made on a gypsum model.
Yeah, and without cadcam.
No. It was made with cadcam. All the design in the D in the CAD and M in the CAM was done in the computer. We had a design in computer based, we had manufacturing computer aided, but the scanning, the impression part was traditional. You don't need to have intraoral scanner to make these types of works. You can also use traditional impression taking. Sometimes it's even easier for some cases because you don't need to maintain all the liquids and blood and saliva that you have in the mouth while you scan with intraoral scanner. You just have your silicone, your transfers, and you just take impressions and it works fine. Then you have a gypsum model and you scan it, or you can scan the tray with silicone or the impression, or you can scan the gypsum model afterwards. But you don't need to have the intraoral scanner to make complicated procedures. Today, almost every laboratory have a technical scanner, like a desktop scanner, and it's good enough for everything that you need.
Here we see a temporary bridge.
Yeah, you can see the temporary bridge.
The sleeve is, I think, is a little bit longer than it should be.
Now, you have some space between the gingiva and the bridge because you want to have a good healing, you have a good maintenance, to have the patient to have a good the ability for a good maintenance of the bridge. So she can clean it up, she can clean above the bridge, below the bridge. In this case, after the extraction, there was the implants were made.
Was the whole wound get infected?
No, it just closes up in about 2 weeks. And you need to wait 3-4 more for the osseointegration and the healing process to complete.
I think, wait.
The central line is displaced.
Yeah, and there is a hole here.
Yeah, the hole is from the old implants, what you see here. We made a temporary bridge right on top of the implant that she had with the multi-units she had. Didn't want to change anything. The frontal teeth, we made exactly as they were before. So
they were offset before also?
Yeah, they were offset before. You had some offset. In here, we marked the offset. Now, to correct the offset before this provisional bridge is very hard. First of all, because you have two teeth, you need to remove from this one and remove from this one, because width of the teeth to be exactly the same, you want them to be symmetrical. Yeah. So you need to remove a lot of material from the teeth. It will interfere with the cementation process. It won't hold. You don't want to involve in the teeth too much. You want to keep her old teeth, make new ones. It's temporary, just 3-4 months. You saw the previous teeth.
It looks much better.
It looks much better. So there is slight shift. Later on, we'll fix it, of course. In here, you can see
the multi-unit.
Yeah, you can see the multi-unit in the implant that was placed. This is after the osseointegration. You can see the gingiva had a little bit of recession. This, you didn't saw it earlier because of the inflammation, because the gingiva was very big. Now you can see the gingiva in a good color. It's quite healthy. So you have little recessions. What you see here is after the osseointegration, after the inflammation gone, you can see healthy tissues and you can see the minimal height of multi-unit, of angulate multi-unit that is available, because in this case the inclination of the implant probably was a buccally inclined, its anterior area. Most cases anterior implants are buccally inclined. There was used angulate multi-unit, and you can see that after the healing process you have some recession and you can see the metal of the angulate multi-unit. So you have very good bridge, looks very nicely, but you can see the metal part of the multi-unit.
So I see, that's why we started producing the new color multi-units.
We chose to anodize the multi-units in a pink color, in tissue color, so even though you have recessions, even though the metal is visible, it will mask a little bit the reflection of the metal through the gingiva. If you have a thin gingiva, it will reflect much less. You'll see different colors. You won't see the gray color that you see in many cases when you have a titanium implant, titanium abutment. And if you have a recession, Pink color is much less visible than metal color, than gray color. This is how it looks in the mouth. You can see that.
Oh, this is the one.
Yeah, this is the one that was colored. You can see these three are angulated multi-units. Mm-hmm. We took one, we colored it, and we used it for this multi-unit specifically. So you can see that this one, you can see the recession, you can see the height of the...
This one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You can see the height of the horizontal part of the multi-unit. You can see that there is about half a millimeter recession, for example. And when it's red, you can see in the next slide that you almost don't see it at all. You don't see the reflection. It's the second part. You'll see it around here. You can see it here.
You don't see reflection, you don't see
the metal part at all. If you look right there, you'll see it, but it's almost invisible.
No, but you really need to...
You need to know that there it's is there, there. Yeah, to, exactly. to see it.
You need to stretch the lip to see it.
Yeah, you need to stretch the lip, but...
When she smiles...
In this case, she has very high smile line. You'll see it, because that is why we made so much effort to mask these things.
Because of the high
smile line. In other cases, we probably won't take this much effort, because you don't see it at all, you need to raise the lip.
That's a cool idea, making it the same color as the gingiva.
Yeah, that's a great idea. This is in the rest position. Mm-hmm. You can see the bridge, the colors, everything. It is probably less informatic picture from all the pictures we had before.
But the smile line.
Yeah, but the smile is good.
That's it?
That's it.
Thank you for being here today.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, send us your interesting cases for us to view them as well. Maybe we'll make a video about one of them. Have a great day and a great weekend.